Hello friends, welcome to the session of Project Life Cycle. I hope you remember that last time we had taken on definition and meaning of project management. Today we will be discussing on project life cycle. Project life cycles are similar for all projects regardless of the size or complexity. There are phases within the project life cycle which occur sequentially, but at the same time there are phases in the project life cycle which overlap each other. Friends, the project life cycle begins from the moment the project has been undertaken for the operation and end when the objective of the project gets accomplished. Let's understand now the importance of project life cycle. All projects consist of a number of different phases that form the life cycle of each project. In the earlier years of the development of the modern project management practices, it was common to see each phase of a project being planned, scheduled, and managed as a separate project from start to finish of each phase. Friends, at the earlier decades, frequently a new project manager would take over as the next phase was started. This usually created conflict and resulted in many unresolved design or other conflicts being swept forward into the next phase. Especially in design, construction, field operation, projects, and as well as IT projects, the new project manager had to solve the problems during different phases of the project which he would be handling. As a result, the cost of operating the plant was often increased due to changes in different phases of the project life cycle of the project. As the project manager discipline matured today, it was recognized and recommended that overlapping these phases, considerable amount of time and money can be saved if the responsibility of the entire project life cycle is given to one project manager. When implemented, this led to fast tracking in the engineering, procurement, construction categories of projects as well as in many other project categories. This led to the development and use today of a number of project life cycle processes, models consisting of phases or stages. Purposes of project life cycle process models. Friends, before going further, let's understand the purpose of project life cycle process modules. The purpose of designing and documenting the overall project life cycle process for any project are: enable all persons concerned with creating, planning, and executing projects to understand the processes to be followed throughout the life of the project. Enable all the project roles and responsibilities and the project planning, estimating, scheduling, monitoring, and control methods and tools to be appropriately related to the overall project life cycle management process. This includes, most importantly, assigning qualified persons to the role of project manager at the proper points in the project life cycle phases. In other words, a well-documented project life cycle model enables us to apply systems thinking to creating, planning, and scheduling and managing the project through all of its phases and to evaluating both the success and the value of the project and the results that the project has produced. Now, let's try to understand the different project life cycle phases. Most projects include at least 4 project life cycles: beginning of the project, planning and organizing the work of the project, performing the work of the project, closing out the project. In other words, in the project development phase, there will always be a gradual build up of resources. This will be followed by a long duration plateau where most of the expenditure would be incurred in terms of planning and organizing of the project and performing of the task related to the project. Towards the end of the phase, there will be a rapid rundown as the project draws to the closure state. Friends, let us try to understand from a simple point of view with the diagram. Let me explain each of the project life cycle phase in detail. Beginning the project. This stage is also known as project initiation, whereby it is the first stage in project life cycle. It essentially involves starting up of the project, and in that the purpose and scope is also defined. Planning and organizing the work of the project. This stage is also known as planning stage, where detailing regarding the project is done. It helps them from the start to end planning. The steps which are involved in the planning stage are creating a project plan, creating a resource plan, creating a financial plan, creating and establishing quality plan and standards, creating a risk handling plan, creating a procurement plan. Last but not the least, the last step is reviewing each stage. Performing the work of the project. In this stage, the project is executed as per the plan in different stages, keeping in mind the time allocation of to each stage and total time allocation to the overall project. Closing out of the project. Project closure means the project has come to an end, and where the client and the stakeholders are being informed, and at the same time the post implementation review is done to find out the success of the overall project. We need to understand that the earlier project cycle phase which you just saw was practiced in earlier days. But today, in most of the sectors and in almost all the projects, new project life cycle model are being followed. Emerging trends. Modern projects differ from those of the past. The fast changing environment have compelled to have certain constraints in the projects like time, cost, legal, ethical, logistic. All this has resulted in risky environments, financial constraints, and changing technology at a rapid pace. These new developments demand control on changes and the project simultaneously at all times. With this has come a new project life cycle model. The project life cycle model that are described in the project management standards today fail to fully recognize the need of the projects prior to the standard project starting or concept phase, and fail to include the importance of post project evaluation of the success of both projects and its product or operating results. Definition of project incubation feasibility phase. The project incubation feasibility phase in the comprehensive project life cycle is the phase prior to initiation of the project starting phase. During this period, necessary information of the potential project is collected, compiled, buffered, and analyzed sufficiently to enable a well-informed decision to proceed with initiation of the project starting phase. The time required for this project feasibility phase will vary from a few days to months, depending on the nature of the industry. Project incubation feasibility phase. When does a project truly start? How does it grow from an idea in someone's head or several head into an approved concept? In almost every case, the standard project starting phase must begin with a reasonable understanding of what the objectives, scope, schedule, and cost of the project are expected to be, including what the project will create, what business benefits will be produced for the organization that will play for the project. Verifying that the project is aligned with the strategic plans and objectives of the sponsoring organization, a reasonable idea of the overall scope of the project together with its expected time schedule, cost, and whether the needed money and other key resources can reasonably be expected to be available and will be verified by producing during the project starting phase. A project will not normally be authorized to enter the project starting phase until sufficient information is available and its feasibility has been established. The basic question here is, where does this initial knowledge and understanding about the potential project come from? This information must be accumulated through a process of information buffering. This information buffering is similar to downloading a movie on your television set. The movie cannot begin until sufficient data and knowledge has been obtained and compiled locally. Project empowerment during the incubation phase. During this incubation period, a project empowerment environment is created. The objective here is to create the mental state that can build the real commitment to the project, raise the effort threshold, motivational factor, project team members, communicating the desired result to the members. Post project evaluation phase. Following the standard project close out phase, the post project evaluation phase that is devoted to the effort needed to first determine and also maintain, improve and even perfect the ultimate success of the project from a project management viewpoint. The project's product and results. All project stakeholders' perspective of both the project and its results, including turnover of people both during the project and after the project closeout phase, and subsequent application of lessons learned for use on future projects. This evaluation phase will also identify weakness and threats that can turn into opportunities that lead to the incubation feasibility phase for future projects of the organization. Friends, the new project lifecycle model is very important in today's context, because a project cannot be undertaken without studying and doing the homework in the project feasibility phase, as today the external environment are beyond the control of the project manager and many risks and uncertainties are involved which needs to be taken account in the project feasibility phase. Friends, project evaluation stage is also very important, part of the overall project life cycle, because after the completion of the project, many times it is not been evaluated whether the purpose for which the project was undertaken is being fulfilled or not. It also helps to learn from the previous mistakes and see that those mistakes are not being repeated in the next projects. Thus, project evaluation is also the need of the hour in all the projects. Who does the post-project evaluation phase benefit? Friends, this is a very important question which always comes in the minds of the people who are not aware of this phase. The primary party that benefits from post-project evaluation phase obviously is the organization that has made the major investment in creating and executing the project, that is the project owner. It is also the stakeholders who would also be benefited from the post-project evaluation phase, as whether the project has given certain return to the stakeholders or not is also of prime importance. Friends, let's now gain some knowledge on the different reasons for the closure of the project. Friends, before going towards the end of the topic, let us understand one more important thing related to project life cycle, and that is the three dimensions for determining project success during the post-project evaluation phase. Project management dimension. How closely did the project achieve what it aimed at? Did the project meet any specific objective which was specified before starting of the project? Product dimension. How well the product achieved its key performance indicators? What were the critical success factors? Stakeholder satisfaction dimension. What level of satisfaction or dissatisfaction exists in the minds of the stakeholders' mind? Friends, there is always a misconception between project closeout phase and project completion phase. Let us understand the difference and compare them. Comparison of the project closeout phase and the post-project completion phase. The traditional project closeout phase encompasses the closing process group that consists of those processes performed to finalize all activities to formally complete the project. Regarding the project evaluation phase, this is the internal project evaluation. The aim here is to assess how successful the project has been. Project success and project value. The concept of project success should be related only to those goals which were precisely defined in the objective of the project. The business goals achieved are the core project value. If there is no success in the project, then the value of the project would become zero and vice versa. project value and project benefit. The organization must have a clear understanding of difference between benefit and value. Value is the quantification of the benefits. In other words, if these benefits actually get materialized, then what is the financial value to the firm? For some projects, value may be difficult to quantify. The actual value may not be able to be determined until we have the beneficial use of it. Many organizations embark on projects simply because for them the benefit looked good on paper, but in reality, these organizations still remain confused in terms of the actual business value of the project which they might determine. Time and duration of the post-project evaluation phase. To measure success at the very first step of project dimension is very easy after the closure of the project. But it is not the same case in terms of second dimension, product dimension, and the third dimension, the stakeholders dimension. These two dimensions usually take longer time to evaluate the success, sometimes months and sometimes longer than that. This post-project evaluation phase will obviously require flexible time depending upon the nature of the project. Relationship between corporate strategy and the project value and project success with reference to incubation feasibility phase. Friends, prior to any beginning of the project, the formulation of the strategy in terms of starting of the project comes from the strategic project manager of the organization. Most organizations today conduct an annual review and reformulation of the strategy for their growth, improvement, and survival for the next few years. In this strategy stage, an organization, whether that is at the highest level or at the lowest level, begins by its strategic business objective. With reference to project life cycle, it is appropriate and necessary to translate the strategic business objectives into more specific key performance indicators. And during the process, it is also important to keep a track that these strategic business objectives themselves do not get lost. In conducting life cycle analysis, it is very important the achievements of all the strategic business objectives represent a pass or fail criteria for any strategy, set of tactics, and a single project or set of projects that are to be undertaken. If the project set objectives are meeting through the criteria of pass, then at the end of the life cycle of the project will give value to its stakeholders and will be perceived as successful. If not, then vice versa case will happen. Thus, we can conclude by saying that in today's context, those organizations which are project driven, that only plan and execute a portion of the overall project, the first dimension, that is project dimension, would only be of primary interest to them with reference to post-project evaluation phase. But in these project driven organizations who plan and execute certain part of the overall project, take the other two dimensions in account with reference to the post-project evaluation phase, they can also benefit a great deal. What we give out, we get back. If we position the project life cycle as mere executing and monitoring discipline, then the success and value of those projects would be at stake. Instead of that, if we treat it as a full-fledged ongoing process, wherein proper planning would be followed by proper execution, proper monitoring, and last but not the least, proper evaluation, then the value and the success of these projects will automatically increase. I hope you must have enjoyed today's session on project life cycle. Thank you.